Bells, community, solace. One cold Sunday morning, the First Congregational Church practices for the day's coming events. From the outside looking in, this seems to be your typical place of worship like any other. However, it isn't the tech crew that makes this place special, but rather the pastor.
I didn't grow up in the church. I came to the church when I was in my early 20s. And the first pastor I ever met, worked with, became someone who was a bit of a mentor for me and started to recognize that I had some skills, some gifts for ministry. So he encouraged me to consider it. And then several years later, there were other pastors that were also making that sort of encouragement for me. My expectations were in ministry, I was going to try to break down a lot of those stereotypes. I was going to help folks know that pastors are just regular people. You know, we live the same lives. I just happen to have a different education and am called into ministry as well.
Mr. Timothy holds an extremely inclusive ministry, which strays from historical norms and adds a special twist to his style of teaching.
Not so much my denomination, but in other Christian experiences, I'm an openly gay man. And so that's different than what a lot of other pastors would expect or a lot of other churches would expect. Within my denomination, it's something that's been celebrated for generations, openly queer folks being ordained into ministry. But I know that for a lot of folks, it's something that's pretty unique.
Though many churches and ministries have openly accepted Timothy's sexuality, he was not always met with support as more conservative churches have pushed back against his style of pastorship, going so far as to refuse gay couples from marriage.
All the churches said, no, we're not doing that. Until I called the First Congregational Church in Randolph, and the woman answered and she said, why, yes, dearie, we are.
Before his association with the church, Paul fought with Mass Equality to secure gay rights in Massachusetts. Once gay marriage was legalized through Obergefell v. Hodges, however, Mass Equality then asked Paul to search for churches that practice gay marriage, to which he found a friend and mentor through Pastor Timothy.
How I feel about it as far as his sexual orientation, being a gay man, is, to me, it's pretty exciting. You know, the fact that I'm also gay and, you know, and so for me to be in a congregation such as this and to have an openly gay pastor is very exciting.
He is awesome. I love Timothy so much because he brings a really different energy than any other pastor that I've ever met before. He's really real with you, and that's something that I really appreciate about him. But he definitely has this way of bringing people together and helping us find what we're passionate about and what we can use our gifts for in the best way possible. And that's something that I really appreciate about him too.
You know, I think that we as faith communities have the ability to influence our wider communities and the world in extremely positive ways. Again, I think there's a lot of really negative stuff out there about churches. There's been a lot of corruption in churches. There's been a lot of scandal in churches, a lot of abuse in churches. So for us to be a community that's really positive and loving and engaged with our wider community, wanting to bring about better experiences or change for the better for folks, I think we can have a lasting impact doing that as well. I would say my biggest message for high schoolers is to, as best you can, live your life authentically. Understand who you are and don't let somebody else put you into a box. Don't let somebody else define how you are to live. Just know who you are and strive to be that every single day of your life.
Pastor Timothy has made inclusivity and acceptance his life's work and leaves behind a lasting legacy of progress. But that's it from me. Back to you in the studio.